Hey, hey monkeys, how you doing? Damien Keyes here. Welcome to EP series number 6. And this one is called The Sweet Spot. So we've talked quite a lot about selling EPs and how you're gonna get distribution, how you're gonna get traction with your EP. But I want you to think about another strategy for your EP, because one thing I see quite a lot, you might recognize this problem, is when you've written songs, you've done the pre-production, you've gone in the studio, you've recorded them, you've done the artwork, you've put them out, and then what happens? Then you wait for a little bit, then after that, a couple of months later, you say, oh, we need to do another EP. And that just a circle goes round and round and round. And so nothing really happens, and the band kind of starts to get a bit of momentum, and then it stops. And then it starts to get a bit of momentum, and then it stops. And I want to keep this momentum going. So this video is called The Sweet Spot. So the sweet spot is probably around the third or fourth release that you're gonna do. Because when you're putting your music out, you want to get your audience into a bit of routine. You want to start getting them used to what it is that you're trying to do. So I want you to start planning and thinking about not this EP, not even the next EP, but probably the fourth EP down the road. If you can do 3 or even 4 EPs in 12 months, that's the one that you're really going to start getting traction on. Because the first time you put out an EP, people are going to go, oh, that's really exciting. Yeah, cool, an EP. The second time is when people say, oh, okay, I can see. Every sort of 3 months or so, you're going to do another one. Okay, I'm starting to get the hang of this. When it gets to the third one, that's when people are going to start getting excited about it. But when it comes to the next one, that's when you're going to build momentum. You're going to have systems in place, and the audience is going to have some kind of routine, knowing what's happening and the way that your band works on this kind of cyclical adventure. When it gets to that fourth one, they know what's coming, and by that point, they know what they need to do. So I want you to almost kind of sign yourself up to a 3 or 4 EP/album deal. And it's up to you when you release them, but if I were you, I wouldn't have too much time in between each one. Imagine if you released, for example, you know, January, April, July, October, something like that. Imagine if you did 4 releases, or if you can only do 3 because of time and money, then you left 3 months in between. So you did January, May, September. Imagine those were your 3 EP dates. Now you're going to be planning September's EP now, whilst you're also planning January's, because you're telling your audience what it is that you're going to do. You're getting them warm for it. You're keeping it excited, but also you're putting systems in place on how you're going to communicate what they need to do and when they need to do it. It will stop this idea of building momentum, getting excited, and then all of the bottom falls out and you're back in a position where you're just waiting for nothing to happen. So I want you to start thinking about 3 or even 4, bring, bring, bring. I want you to think about 3 or even 4 EPs time. And that way, what you're gonna do is you're gonna start getting your audience ready. Have a think about that. Have a think about what's feasible. You get to put the time frame on it. If you want it to be every 3 months, every 4 months, every 6 months, but we are in a time now where you've got to keep music short in between when you're releasing it. So people aren't gonna wait a year for your next release. People probably aren't gonna wait 3 or 4 months for a single. They're gonna want 3 or 4 tracks every couple of months, minimum. So it's up to you what you do, but you've gotta try and fit this into a calendar, and then you're gonna come up with a bit of a routine of how you're gonna promote it, and that should help with building momentum. You're gonna take 2 steps forward, then a little bit of a step back while you're promoting it, then 2 steps forward, then 1 step back, and you're continually moving forward the whole time. Good, have a think about it. And if you haven't seen any other videos, then go back to number 1, for the EP series, all on the YouTube, youtube.com/Damien Keyes. Like, subscribe, and comment down below. Let me know what number EP you're on and what your plans are for the next few months. Cool, take it easy, I'll see you tomorrow.